In this video, we'll be discussing the history behind some of the most popular stadiums that have laid the foundation for and evolved into the modern stadiums today. If you haven't subscribed to our channel by now, please click on the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. Ancient Greek stadiums. The ancient Greeks thrived on athletic competitions. The oldest Panathenaic Stadium of Athens was built in 330 BC and stands even today with a capacity of 50,000. In 2004, it was used for the Olympics and is the world's only stadium made of marble. The Olympic Games have been held since 776 BC. The oldest known stadiums of Olympia in Greece were built to conduct the thrilling games of the Olympics, where thousands of people flooded the stadium to get a good view of the competition. They were often built on hillsides, which allowed the audience a clear view. The only known and significant competition of the games was the stadion, which was a 200-yard race on foot upon the clay surface of the stadium. After the immense success of the Olympic Games in ancient Greece, the games were banned for almost a millennium after they were declared pagan. The amphitheaters of Rome. The Romans built amphitheaters, which were circular stadiums that allowed audiences from all angles to get a good view of the event. The Roman population thrived on mass entertainment, which allowed for several innovative events to be held inside the amphitheaters that included elaborate animal hunts, executions, theater plays, and most popular of all, gladiator fights. The famous Roman Colosseum can hold up to 60,000 people. Horse and chariot races took place in the Circus Maximus. These events got dangerously intense and thrilling, and were so famous that we now know about them through popular films like Gladiator and Ben-Hur. What followed next was the fall of the Roman Empire and the rise of Christianity. The Dark Ages saw a pause in stadium construction, which continued into the Middle Ages. The architectural focus of these ages was solely on churches and cathedrals. It was 1896 that the Olympic Games were revived by the efforts of Pierre de Coubertin, which allowed for the restoration of stadiums as important structures of civic and cultural interests. This period coincided with the Industrial Revolution, which largely produced steel, iron, and new technology that was invested in modernizing and refurbishing stadiums in the interest of the urban public. It wasn't until the formulation and promotion of the relatively modern sports such as cricket, football, soccer, and baseball that the mass population's interest in stadiums surged. Sporting stadiums brought back to life. The English architects revived the stadiums in the 1800s. The oldest known stadium is the Lord's Cricket Ground that hosts matches even today. In 1868, the England Lawn Tennis and Croquet Club was conceived to be the home of one of the world's prestigious events, Wimbledon. America was catching up with the other side of the world, and it was baseball that instigated the building of stadiums. Fenway Park, which has long been the home of the Red Sox, and Wrigley Field in Chicago were built to match the craze of the sports population. In 1895, the Franklin Field of the University of Pennsylvania became the first football stadium. Liverpool of England saw the building of Goodison Park, another English football stadium that continues to remain in service to this date along with Goodison Park. The city planning organizations of the governments too came forward to invest in stadium design and construction, which resulted in the modern and refurbished stadiums of today. The modern stadiums. The modern era brought into the mainstream some major sporting events such as the World Cup, the Olympics, FIFA, which are events that millions around the world tune into using their televisions and phones and get highly priced tickets to watch and cheer. With the sporting industry realizing the worth of such enthralling matches, investments in innovative and multi-purpose stadiums are all that have been at the top of the agenda. The aim of these stadiums is not only push for spectators' experience, but also to enhance the pride of the city that they're located in. The Bird's Nest in Beijing drew immense awe when it was unveiled during the Summer Olympics of 2008. It was only in the 1980s that a massive design change was made as a part of stadiums, a convertible roof. The weather plays a major role when it comes to sports, and some sports require to be solely indoors or outdoors. If the weather plays against it, then it hinders the event. The Sky Dome in Canada was built in 1989 and is still fully functional. It has a roof that can be opened and closed in about 20 minutes at the touch of a button. Another marvelous example is the Sapporo Dome in Japan, where, interestingly, the natural turf rolls out of the retractable walls of the stadium when it's not in use. The main motive behind such innovations is not simply for the benefit of the sport or the audience, but rather the large profits that these sporting events generate. Using all the available technology to install digital amenities and facilities wherever possible, sports stadiums no longer conform to a conventional mold. Among the stadiums that are in construction and are eagerly awaited for is the Las Vegas Raiders Stadium. It promises an enhanced technological and architectural addition to the city's skyline. Making use of the innovative supplies that have come about, the stadium has put into use new materials such as ETFE, which is a fabric resembling glass which will be made use of in the walls and the roof of the stadium. In the past, what had been developed as simple venues to avoid boredom have evolved in the present into megastructures that host major sporting events. While the cultural and civic importance of the structures remain, they also carry the added pressures of turning in profits for the largely lucrative sports industry. We've come to the end of this video. If you liked watching us, please like and share this video. We'll be back soon with yet another interesting video for you to watch, but until then, keep watching us.